x264 versus NVENC. With a surge in interest in streaming platforms such as Twitch or YouTube, I've received a whole bunch of questions regarding which one of these is better. Each one has their own different hardware requirements, yet I still find people asking, "Turk, why on earth would you stream with those options?" Well, let's clear that all up now, shall we? Hey guys, Turk here. I hope you're having a splendid day. I like to add a bit to my processor reviews, not to echo many of the other reviewers out there. Streamers and content creators are continuously encoding on their machines, so it makes sense to throw x264 encoding into my benchmark suite in order to see how the different processors can handle the load. However, streaming settings and encoding options are a huge, heavily debated topic here on the internet, and for my reviews in particular, many people have posed the question of which of these options is best to use. So rather than just say, go X264 slow or go home, I want to show which of these options actually is best. If you're looking for a low-level analysis of X264 versus encoding options, I highly recommend checking out Epos Vox's video, linked down below for details. For my purposes today, though, I want to take a similar approach to his and apply it to what processors or GPUs you should be buying for your latest PC builds. Also, I wanted to look at a handful of styles of games that regularly top the charts on Twitch and see just what kind of combination impacts the video quality. Now, before I get too deep into the details, here's the time code to jump to my test's visual comparisons and today's results. If you want to understand the numbers or what they actually mean, just sit tight, we're only going to be scratching the surface here. In order to objectively compare each of these approaches today, I want to introduce you to Netflix's Video Multi-Method Assessment Fusion, or VMAF. I'll provide some links in the description in case you want to learn just a bit more about the specifics, but VMAF is Netflix's approach of approximating a streamed video's quality based on both human and machine learning analysis. As a company that spends countless hours of time encoding and delivering large amounts of data to their customers, Netflix needed to come up with a way to compare the encoding efficiency and their delivery strategies in order to optimize video quality versus the payload size. With VMAF, they've collected user-generated scores for a variety of clips from different movies on their platform, with scores ranking between excellent and poor. They feed this data into their machine learning model in order to train the results to match their library's more extensive sample set. Based on research on some compression techniques, as well as viewing distances, display size, and resolutions, their model compares a golden file against an encoded version of that same file and estimates a numeric score that maps to their user-generated scores from earlier. For us, this sounds great and gives us an indicator as to which encoding options are in fact best for our streaming experience. Sure, there are other metrics for encoding quality such as PSNR and SSIM, but the VMAF tool is easier to consume and leads to a better conclusion of what looks better. For our experiment today, we have first to capture a lossless video sample of our gameplay. With the right hardware as well as plenty of storage, this task is pretty straightforward. I'll be capturing full screen 1440p gameplay through my 4K 60 Pro in OBS with NVENC's lossless setting on a 1080p canvas. Though not the best way to get lossless video, it works for our first run at this experiment. To expedite the data collection, I'll be compressing each of these different video samples with bit rates of 2000, 4000, and 6000 kbps. I will also use three different popular encoding methods such as X264 medium, slow, and NVENC with the high quality preset. After encoding, we simply feed the files into the application through the command line and bada bing bada boom, we've got a result. Not so fast. This experiment seems simple, but there are a bunch of caveats to take into account for answering our questions from before. First, we are no longer looking at a qualitative comparison against three different sample streams. We are now feeding the same golden file into Handbrake and then re-encoding each file, thus removing the gameplay element from our streaming reviews. I will be taking account of this in our results. For comparison, I'll put in my graphs references to the instances where my different benchmarks, the specific processor failed to run the game live and encode the stream at the same time. Now, it was a different setup, but it was also at a lower resolution and a rescaled 720p, so keep that in mind going forward. Also, the tool itself is very slow. Though Netflix has published improvements to their GitHub page, the current implementation of their command line option does not leverage all of my multi-core CPU, and VMAF processes videos at an impressive 2 to 3 frames per second. So I'm only going to be looking at about a minute and a half of footage for each game today. Lastly, the VMAF scores are only representative to the specific clips we feed into it. There could be instances where this particular clip encodes cleaner, so if you want to see more varieties in clips from different games, that's just gonna have to come from another video. With that out of the way, guys, let's talk the games. I've got clips from Cyberpunk 2077, Modern Warfare, Doom Eternal, F1 2020, and Shadow of the Tomb Raider. I'll be presenting to you each of these clips on the screen at once so you can directly compare the footage against one another. Since this is a 4K video, I highly recommend watching it at that resolution, as YouTube might itself distort the quality of the different videos at other resolutions. I have not run Cyberpunk 2077 through my CPU benchmarks yet, so what you see is what you get. This clip is taken at the end of Act 1 as we escape the hotel. I would have personally chosen a silent takedown in this particular instance, but that doesn't really look good for a clip, so I went in guns blazing. This is running at ray tracing medium settings while tweaking the options with Digital Foundry's recommended settings. Due to the scene's darkness and relatively static backgrounds, each of the encodes looks surprisingly good. I'd also say that even if we go outside, the game will likely encode well, inducing mild motion from running around Night City. I would also expect that driving sequences in the third person would encounter harsher encoding loss due to the increased motion. Our VMAF scores show with a meager 2000 kbps bitrate, each encoding option is just below good with the VMAF index. Increasing to 4000K presents impressive results. We do see diminishing returns going up to 6000 kbps here, though putting the encoder side by side, NVENC gets the edge here at the lower bit rates, but honestly guys, at 4000K, they're all about even. Next up is Doom Eternal. This clip is about halfway through my benchmark run, where the first stage starts to open up and we get to just see how much love and attention to detail id Software puts into this game. At 1440p and Ultra Nightmare detail settings, we maximize graphical quality while still maintaining over 120 FPS with our RTX 2080 Super. Sticky bombs, explosions, ice grenades, this clip is just a glimpse of how crazy this game can get. Encoding the clip, though, is another story. As we mentioned in our 5600 versus 3700X review, to encode this game with live gameplay will require a significant CPU horsepower, with even an 8-core processor struggling to maintain 4000 kbps x264 encode. To add insult to injury, the VMAF results for this game are less than stellar. Compared to the golden file, each encoded clip stair-steps the VMAF index from poor at 2K, fair at 4K, and good at 6000 kbps. Ideally, this game would require additional bitrate if you can spare it. On the bright side though, the NVENC encoder continues to excel here, particularly in the lower bitrate settings. This result goes to show the strength of Nvidia's latest encoder and reinforces my recommendations from my CPU reviews. Let's look at the other end of the spectrum with Shadow of the Tomb Raider. I've used this benchmark many times due to its reliability and its short execution times, and this clip captures the second and third scenes in the built-in benchmark. We start in the forest with plenty of foliage creating a dramatic shading effect, while slow, gentle motion breaks up the scene just enough to make it interesting. The landscape footage is stunning, and zooming in into the town does highlight the graphical disparity between some of the rendered objects in the game. This clip is captured with the highest detail preset with no ray trace shadows or DLSS running. Just as we saw with Cyberpunk, Shadow of the Tomb Raider encodes very well with 2000 bitrate landing just below good and quality plateaus around 4000 kbps. Interestingly here is the fact that x264 shows a distinctive advantage to NVENC when encoding this specific scene. This proves that encoding is not a one-size-fits-all affair, and clearly part selection helps generate a better experience. Adding on to that, our 5600X failed to encode the game at the higher bitrate settings with x264 slow preset. Call of Duty Modern Warfare is a fan favorite here on the channel, and this clip is from our Piccadilly single player campaign. With dramatic lighting, both open and compact quarters, as well as plenty of AI running around, this mission is a great representation of actual gameplay. Compared to our previous games, this game shows a mix of slow-paced backgrounds with intense moments of action. We see VMAF score behavior similar to Cyberpunk at 4000 and 6000K, and this game needs a bit more bitrate than 2000kbps to provide a good encoding quality. And though our post-process renders offers an impressive quality output, creating that kind of output with x264 in real time requires a significant processor strength and likely would benefit from streaming with NVENC. This also does show that 8-core processors, in general, handle this type of application better than their 6-core counterparts. Bringing it home today is F1 2020, another benchmark favorite of mine, which provides a mix of perspectives, environments, and repeatability that I can rely on. Though not as graphically stunning as the Forza or Dirt series, this simulation game delivers the F1 experience at high frame rates and detail settings. Hovering about 100 FPS with settings at ultra high is an immersive time for the gamer, but does that translate to a viewer? As we drive the track in excess of 150 miles per hour, our encoders do appear to struggle to keep pace in most cases. Fencing and foliage appear as smudges in the background, and that does get quantified by the VMAF tool. At 2000K, the footage is just above the poor classification, and we appear to love additional bitrate, similar to how Doom performed. Unlike with Doom Eternal, x264 does appear to be marginally better at each of the bit rates, though that improvement might not be discernible to most people. As for part selection, the 6-core 5600X fails to maintain the 6000kbps slow encode, so either bump that down to medium setting for a similar effect, or stick to Nvidia's NVENC. Having watched the clips, did any of them stick out to you? Let me know down in the comments which of these encoder settings looked the best to you. We're putting a lot of weight behind Netflix's ranking system here, so there might be flaws to this tool in this particular application. With that said, let's hit up some conclusions. Putting the games all side by side, let's step through the bit rates. In general, it's best to say that the slower the gameplay is, the less bit rate is necessary for a good viewing experience. However, if your internet connection and your computer hardware can encode it, stepping up to 4000kbps is a great middle ground between bandwidth usage and quality. And if you strive for a good stream, you'll need to be streaming at Twitch's maximum non-partnered rate of 6000kbps. Important note, these clips are all from a 1080p source file and 1080p rendered files. It is entirely possible that moving to a 720p rendered file could change the quality of your video at different bit rates. If you want me to take a look at that, hit me up over on Twitter. Next, and honestly, probably what you guys came to see this video, is what encoder should you use? Through my VMAF analysis, x264 Slow provides the best quality in 4 of the 5 games tested today at higher bit rates. However, is that worth the computational requirements? I think the better question is, at each of these bit rates, can you tell the difference? In almost all of the instances, excluding Shadow of the Tomb Raider, each bitrate result was less than 5 points between the best and worst encoder. For probably 80% of the viewers out there, I'd bet that the answer is no, I can't tell the difference. But in Twitch's competitive landscape, maybe that extra quality can translate into a better viewing experience. Now, I'm by no means saying go out and buy a $700 processor to make your stream look 5% better, but the best quality does require you to push past the point of diminishing returns. Now, let's not forget that the VMAF tool is built on assumptions and specific data. A particular score is built on an assumed view distance and a particular device and a particular resolution. Suppose most of your viewers are on mobile device. If that's the case, there's a good chance that the VMAF score will increase due to the updates to Netflix's inclusion of their mobile dataset model. Hardware recommendations then. For GPUs, I still recommend users to pick up Nvidia's 1650 Super or better GPUs because it's really hard to beat their latest NVENC encoder even when only doing minimal encoding work. If you've got your eyes on AMD's latest GPUs, I would definitely recommend pairing it with a competent processor for encoding since AMD's encoders are known to have less perceived quality. For CPUs, I strongly recommend going with an 8-core processor here. Sure, a 5600X paired with Nvidia's latest GPUs will stream fine for now. As we saw in our Call of Duty results, 6-cores start to run out of steam a bit, and future games will begin to embrace more cores. Streaming aside, why buy a processor that could leave you wanting in the next year or two? Check out my Zen 3 reviews for more comparisons between the 3700X and the 5600X, or better yet, the 8-core 5800X versus the 5900X for a more future-proof comparison. With all that said, streaming quality for the most part boils down to bitrate, and if you have modern hardware and decent internet, either approach will get you streaming in no time. If you've got the latest Nvidia's GPUs, NVENC is hard to look past and will handle most of the games you will likely play. If you want to go the x264 route, you have been warned about the costs and the hardware requirements. It does provide a better stream, even if it's only marginally better. This video has taken a lot of computation time for me to deliver, but I'm glad that I've finally gotten time to do this analysis. If you guys want me to make more VMAF comparison videos of hardware, games, or anything else streaming related, let me know down below. If you wish to participate in the process, jump into my Discord. I regularly drop my data in there for you guys to chew on and to provide me feedback. Thanks you guys for watching. I hope to see you in the next one. Take care, Turk Force. Oh, and Happy New Year.